Hi, this is Grace Pamela with Summerana.com, and this is the preview and tutorial for the Luminosity Lights Flare Overlay and Action Collection. So here are a few before and afters. Here are some more, just to show you what they do. And here's an image that I'm going to be working on. So I already have my Action Collection uploaded. Now the first thing I'm going to want to do is go to Apply Flare Overlay. I'm going to press Play and select a flare that I would like. To resize it, you hold down the Shift key and drag the corners, or you can select this link here and that will hold it for you. And you press the check mark, and there you have your flare. You can rotate it or resize it. I'm gonna flip it, and you can also move it around. If you would like it to be darker, so a lot of images won't always have it so that you can see it clearly, such as lighter images, you can always duplicate it. So right click, and duplicate later. Press OK, and you can do that as many times as you'd like. Then select both of them, and click Merge Layers. And then click Screen. And there you have your duplicated layer. Now you can go to your flare editor. You can change the color. You can add more flare color. And you can change the opacity for each layer. You can also simmer down. I'll show you what simmer down does. It makes it a little darker. Another thing you can do is brush on parts of your flare. So let's say I don't really want it on her face as much. I would use a soft white paintbrush on the black layer mask, and you can adjust the opacity of your brush. Then you can brush over the areas where you don't really want the flare as bright. If you want to get rid of part of your flare completely, there should already be a layer mask, but you can add a new one by adding a Reveal All Layer Mask, or you can click this little mask down here. And then you can get rid of part of it completely. You can also blur your flare. You have to make sure the actual flare layer is selected though, and not the layer mask or any of these, before you play these. You can also make it a little brighter. And to your whole image, you can select more color. Just to make sure it's not added on as a clipping mask, you can right click and select Release Clipping Mask, and it will add it to your whole image. If you don't want your flare also with more color, as you can see here, you can drag this down below, and then that way it'll just affect the image below it. Completely up to you and how you want it to look. You can also warm up or cool down. Again, you can adjust the opacity here. And you can also add hazy light if you'd like. Press continue and select any color in your image or anything in your color picker box. And there you have it. I'm going to show you on a different image really quick. Apply an overlay. I like to drag it a little past your image, so it's overlapping just a little bit, just to make sure that it's not going to show any edges. You press the check mark. Press continue. Now this is a little bright, so I'm going to select Simmer Down and make the opacity go way up. It looks a little better. It's still a lot on her face, so I'm going to brush on Simmer Down. Press Continue. I'm going going to brush it down on her a little bit and a little on the horse. If you make a mistake, you can select a black soft brush in your black layer mask and just paint it right back on. Another way you can do it, you can multiply this a few times. So if you want it even darker, you can do that as many times as you'd like, or you can actually paint in your layer mask on your flare with a black soft paintbrush and then just kind of brush it off. Completely up to you on how you like it. Each image will be different. There you go. You can also add more color, warm up. Now I'm going to take you into Photoshop Elements. I'm going to apply a flare overlay. Again, hold the Shift key down to make it bigger or smaller. And then select the little green check mark here. Now this one is on the, you can see when you move it around, it's lighter on the lighter backgrounds and darker on the darker. So again, you can do the same thing. You can right click and duplicate. And hold both layers, merge layers, screen, and you can also add layer mask. And then you can simmer down to make it darker or whatever you'd like. I also want to show you there are movable lights and there are ones that aren't so movable. So movable ones would be the ones like this where it's not coming off the edges here. So for example, let's say I like this one, but you can see the blue is coming off the edge here. So let's say I just wanted the yellow. And I didn't want it all over my entire image. See how you can see the edge here? To get rid of that, you just paint in the white layer mask with a black paintbrush. And you can just paint your edges off. If it's still a little obvious that you erased that, you can adjust the opacity of your brush, make it a little bigger so it's a little more natural looking, and then go over it. That way it'll blend in better. Everything else is pretty much the same as in Photoshop. Add more color. You can also brush it off parts of it that you don't want more color. And to adjust your brush here, you can choose a soft one by scrolling through here. And to change the brush settings to hard from soft, here's your hardness right here. So you can make it at 0% for a soft brush. You can change your flare color by selecting your flare and pressing play. Press continue. And again, you can choose any color in your color picker box or in your image. It can literally be any color that you like. Press OK. If you don't want your entire flare a different color, like I like this little rainbow up here, you can just brush off that part. And again, if you want it to look a little more natural, make your your brush a little bigger so it'll blend in a little. Just an example. You can also adjust the opacity. You can also change the color again by double-clicking this box, and you can change the color to whatever you like. You can also add a hazy light, press continue, choose any color that you like. Press OK. And again, you can select a different color again by double clicking the box. You can also adjust the opacity. You can also cool down, warm up, same as in Photoshop. And that's pretty much it. Thank you so much for watching. If you're interested in this collection, you can go to summerana.com.